We got out what we could get out. Most of it's ruined.
Nev and Conrad spend most of the morning hauling out wet clothes under 3 feet of water in his friend's basement apartment. At 3:30 Monday morning, a chunk of ice broke through what used to be a retaining wall and smashed right into the back door.
That was all glass down there, and that's what was there. Somehow the glass didn't break, but the doors ripped off.
It all began Saturday morning when water slowly began to rise towards the homes here along the Des Moines River. Neighbors watched closely, but they weren't terribly concerned yet.
Saturday night, it sounded like a thunderstorm out here. We heard low rumblings.
That rumbling was pieces of ice hitting the back of Ian Bartholomew's house.
You see the wall?
No.
Well, that's because it's underwater. And that's almost 5 foot high, the retaining wall.
There wasn't much time to react. Ian did what he could before he was forced to evacuate.
We had enough time to stack furniture on countertops and stuff, and then the water went down a little bit, and then bam.
Neighbor Dennis Frank was also surprised by how quickly the water rushed into his home. He went out, bought 4 pairs of waterproof pants, and enlisted help from his family. They weren't able to save much.
We'll get out, let the water go down, and see what the contractors say.
But it could be weeks before that happens. Meanwhile, all the neighborhood can do is pack up, ship out, and hope the rest of this ice moves down the river.
What else are you going to do? I'm not going to lay down in the water and cry about it.